one thing was the angle was a little.
It wasn't.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's make sure we get the angle right so that it works. Okay. Third position we know is cool. And that's all stuff that you've done before. So that's where it's coming from. Stuff that you had experienced playing before. Now, a little bit of constructive criticism. When you're going to use this type of a melody, like you do in the beginning, and it repeats again, somewhere, either the first or the second time, put. Because when you put it together with, it kind of gets an effect that you're not just repeating, that you've actually put a little bit more thought, or that you're trying to put a little bit more detail into how you're dealing with your melodies. It doesn't, you know, you don't have to do it, but it's a way to make things less repetitive, which is always a flamenco way to go. Repetitive in kind of the tone of the thing, but the melodies never get repeated. Well, they don't, it's not that they never do, but it's nice when they don't repeat verbatim and they sound like, you know, how a singer in a different verse, in the second verse of a tune that has the same melody, it's not exactly the same, it kind of makes it fresh. So. Sixth fret on the third string that you can use to create a really interesting effect. Now, you keep the F in the bottom, and this chord is a fairly complex chord, but what it's hinting at is A, a fairly normal chord. Flat fourth fret instead of the fifth fret on the first string. It's a little more exotic sound. And then try doing this with a thumb. Also try position, the textures you can do. Piccolo is another option, not fast piccolo, but position, which is the most popularly used one. You got your bar there. You got your open fifth string, and then your third fret here. But then you've got three, and then we sometimes carefully use the fifth fret. The sixth fret is safe. Third fret on the second string is cool, ready to go. Fifth fret, great. and 6th fret there. 3rd fret on the 1st string. 5th fret is always going to be easy to hear. That's one, the one that you picked on both passes of your falsetto. And the B flat safe. Alright, so basically 6, 5, 3, 6, 5, 3, 6, 5, 3 is all good to go. Watch out for this one, these two notes. You kind of sometimes choose one or the other. To kind of be careful around there and play around with a couple of different ideas before you finalize everything. The one note to look out for and try to use, but make sure you're using it in a way to create an effect that's very Arabic. Exotic. And then if you can find a way to come back in somewhere in there to the A, F, C sharp, and E, that's a really nice chord. And even put the G in there. But a lot of the stuff I come up with comes from these noodling around with these things. And you've seen me compose before, and I start out with an idea and spin my wheels on it till I find something that I really like. And really, until something starts to fall into place. I'm a little bit lazy about it. I want to, you know, scatter the ingredients around and just start throwing them in a bowl and go, fuck it, throw it on the stove, cook it, and see what's there, which is a very flamenco way, a little bit of chance involved in there, and then instead of trying to be a musical genius, a Mozart or something, to go, oh, I know perfectly where everything goes in there. I mean, that would be great, you know, I could stand a little bit of that myself, but I'll do it the other way. This other way is cool. You let the universe compose the music a little bit, you know, or at least it feels that way. Maybe it's your subconscious, who knows. All right, 3rd position. 2nd position is the notes that you can choose from, or you can choose any of them, but the ones that are going to automatically out of the starting gate sound really great are 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 5, and then here, if you're going to go up on the 1st string, you need to go 1, 3, 5. Second finger that you play the 3rd fret with, and lift up and pivot to do that. Okay, now also, though, the F sharp is also another color. It's a little bit more optimistic than optimistic. It's a little happier, but it's still very flamenco. But you're putting together the F sharp with this B flat, and those two notes together create an interesting effect. Thank you. first fret. You've got the open A and the first fret, which creates a tritone, which is sometimes referred to the devil's interval, which is funny. It's hilarious. The reason why is because it creates a diminished effect where you, it just kind of repeats and repeats symmetrically into infinity, where you have this chord right here. Let's see, we've got this right here. It's the same four notes, just repeat into infinity in a different order. E flat, A, C, G flat, G flat, C, E flat, yeah, there was the A there, and the same thing, you just start shifting, and I don't know, it has a dastardly sound. It's the chord they use when they're on the old silent films, when they're tying the chick to the railroad tracks. I tend to never ever use that trick, even though I know it pretty well, because it's very guitaristic. It's something that works well on the guitar, and if you don't know about it, you can nerd out on it for a couple of weeks, and then you go, oh man, there's some other things that we could be doing in here. But that's what a tritone is. Beyond that, we've got the second fret instead of here, because this is unresolved and it's got a lot of tension. It's dissonant, but it's good as long as it's not, you're not trying to resolve anything. Sometimes I like the third fret on the second string. Sometimes I like this, the second fret. All of them are wrong. So it's the degree to wrong you want to be, you know? But they don't sound that wrong when you do them right. That doesn't make any fucking sense, but it does. One, three, four on the top. and happy. where if you just start out with this, it's kind of, it's not as dramatic because it hasn't been placed next to something so optimistic or so happy sound. Hopeful. Now at the fifth fret, open five, then here we have 7-6. Thank you. open the seven, and on the third string you have 7-9, 7-8-10, 7-9-10 on the first string. 9-10. That aren't those bars, because you need a little bit more to deal with than just that. There's the stuff that I ended with that will be for Ramathis, but I'm going to get to that too, but I want to give you these a couple of chords to mess around with too. They're bigger chords, and it'll be a good exercise for you to work on the fingering of these chords to get used to making them sound like something. This is a fancy ass D minor chord, but it's spread out across the fretboard. It's 5, 7, 3, 6 open. Then what you're gonna do is bar at the third fret, but leave these two fingers where they're at. So you have 3, 7, 3, 6. Lift the bar up and just come over there like that. And you've got a really fancy G minor chord. And then if you want to bring it home to an A chord or a por medio resolution chord, you invert these two fingers like that. So even though it's a big stretch of a chord, there's some other nice stuff right around it. My guitar's not getting more in tune. The more I tune it, it's getting more out of tune. With a D minor. All you're doing for the next chord in the series is adding a C. A B flat. But to keep that down, you have to kind of move over. And you'll kind of have to, you'll have to support yourself. You have to go, you can do it. You just kind of hop over, but you do have to bend over this direction on the side of your finger to make it happen. You can pull off to open, grab the G, but when you do, with your pinky, put back the B flat, and you get a really cool G minor chord there. Demands to be resolved to here, to E, like a solea, but it's brief because you got to get back to A, so you put things back with that chord there, and then you resolve. So between these two things here, to do it out of order and find a different order, but I've got a melody cruising in the bass that's following a particular order. But there's nothing to say you can't go. not showing this for you to learn it in any particular order, but I'm giving an example of an order that works. But until you go and play with it to see what and where you can take these colors once you get your fingers to make the sound, that's where all the creative part will come in. And your ear and all the stuff you've heard, from what I can tell with what you did with the tientos idea, should fall into place, more or less. I can probably predict that it'll be a little bit simpler an idea than I hear right off the bat, because I've been looking for shit for a long time that's different, because you get tired of hearing. Flamenco, but it'll also sound cliched, and even some of this other stuff can be cliched if it doesn't get dealt with in a clever way. But that goes for everything. I mean, we've got 12 notes we're working with. It comes back to that. We're kind of using limited resources to create a lot of music for the last 250, 300, 400 years now since they started writing stuff down. So we've kind of gotten away with a lot with these 12 notes. I guess the math would give a lot of different, the probabilities are, there's a lot of stuff going on there, but really, I don't know. I mean, if you looked at it back then and go, man, for the next 400 years, you can use these 12 pitches, you're gonna come up with all kinds of shit all over the world with them. I could probably say, I don't know, man. I think we might need a few more. Like the Indians, like maybe we need quarter tones. Maybe we need a 24 note system. But not everything you can do. It's two sets of cool, really three. But these two things are kind of related, because they're both kind of one position you hold and move over different bass notes to create different chords without moving very much, is what's going on. There's this thing which we've used too much. But you can use it too much too. I use it too much. The cool thing about this thing is it taken up in the third position and repeated. Magical. On most guitars, with the capo on the second fret, it gets that thing going on at the end, which, in a noisy club, that nuance never cuts through. But when you're at home by yourself with your guitar, it's doing some of the work for you, the guitar, the tool, So check those chords out and see what else you come up with. Not necessarily for tientos, but just to put sounds together. Eventually, start to craft them into slow 4/4 for tientos. But really now, just try to make those sounds. Try to make some sounds and try to go, that is dark, that's light. Decide for yourself. Don't just take my word for it or my description of it. Kind of figure out what's going on there and how you hear it and how you might use those different shades of doing things. See what you come up with just as sounds. Leave the rhythm out of the picture for a while. Relative in kind of the tone of the thing, but the melodies never get repeated. Well, they don't. It's not that they never do, but it's nice when they don't repeat verbatim, and they sound like, you know, how a singer in a different verse, in the second verse of a tune that has the same melody, it's not exactly the same. It kind of makes it fresh. So and then don't forget this sixth fret on the third string that you can use to create a really interesting effect. Now, you keep the F in the bottom, and this chord is a fairly complex chord, but what it's is hinting at is a fairly normal chord. Same thing with A flat, fourth fret, instead of the fifth fret on the first string. You picked on both passes of your falsetto, and the B flat safe. Alright, so basically 6-5-3, 6-5-3, 6-5-3 is all good to go. Watch out for this one, these two notes. You kind of sometimes choose one or the other. Or you can do is both, but you just have to kind of be careful around there and play around with a couple of different ideas before you finalize everything. The one note to look out for and try to use, but make sure you're using it in a way to create an effect that's very Arabic. Exotic. If you can find a way to come back in somewhere in there to the A, F, C sharp, and E, that's a really nice chord. And even put the G in there. Second position now. That, I heard you do that, and that actually sounded pretty cool. Let's call the frets out here. Let me go back to the third position, which is the most popularly used one. You got your bar there. You got your open fifth string. And then your third fret here. But then you've got three. And then we sometimes carefully use the fifth fret. The sixth fret is safe. Third fret on the second string is cool, ready to go. Fifth fret, great. And sixth fret there. Third fret on the first string. Fifth fret is always going to be easy to hear. That's one. The one.
Well, that was one thing. It was the angle was a little.
It wasn't.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's make sure we get the angle right, so that it works. Okay. Third position we know is cool, and that's all stuff that you've done before. So that's where it's coming from. Stuff that you had experience playing before. Now, a little bit of constructive criticism. When you're going to use this type of a melody, like you do in the beginning, and it repeats again, somewhere, either the first or the second time, put, because when you put it together with an effect that you're not just repeating, that you've actually put a little bit more thought, or that you're trying to put a little bit more detail into how you're dealing with your melodies. It doesn't, you know, you don't have to do it, but it's a way to make things less repetitive, which is always a flamenco way to go. Repetitive, it's a little more more exotic sound. And then try doing this with a thumb. Also try... position, the textures you can do. Piccolo is another option, not fast piccolo, but